So few days back, these types of videos were going viral on Instagram Reels. Well, I'm not an extra smart person, but from my simple understanding, in the first portion, the girl looks sad because she has got a dark skin, and in a flash, she transforms herself into a fair skin or white skin girl, and now she is happy. Well, there were many other videos with millions of views, and Instagram had to ban this filter as it was promoting racism. But this brings back a very interesting conversation. That is the Indian obsession with fair skin. The same obsession which has helped products like Fair & Lovely generate billion-dollar revenue every year. Associating beauty standards with fair skin has been the furtive norm in India for decades. And people with such fair skin were the ones who used to qualify to become successful actors in the Indian cinema. But if you do a comparative study of Bollywood and Mollywood, the Malayalam film industry has gone through a drastic change over the past 10 years. Malayalam cinema has seen the emergence of strong female lead roles, while Bollywood still continues to portray them as mere glamour dolls, or as sidekick characters, or for an item song to spice things up. Well, I'm not saying that Bollywood has not at all done strong female-oriented movies. There have been great movies like Kahani, English Winglish, Queen, Mardani, Mary Kong, and Pink. But the success ratios of these movies have been comparatively less, and most of them have ended up as average films. While the ladies of other film industries usually prefer straightened hair and are never seen on the screen without skin imperfections or dark circles under their eyes, the Malayalam film industry has frequently shown the female lead roles as they are, preferring a natural look that suits the character they are playing. The direction and the script has been so amazing such that the looks of an actress has become secondary now. Of course, we have had some legendary actors too in our industry who have proved that to become a quality actor, you do not need to come with a fair skin, six-pack abs, or with a beast body. But all that matters is to master the art of acting. But in this particular video, I want to speak about three female legends from the Malayalam film industry who have literally smashed and redefined beauty standards in the recent times. And by the end of this video, the story is not just going to be about them, but also about you and me. Number 1. Aparna Balamurli in Maheshinde Pradhigaram, one of the best movies of the year 2016. The character Mahesh, played by Fahad, runs a digital photography studio in the Idukki district of Kerala. The character Jimsy Augustine, a young college girl played by Aparna Balamurli, goes to the photography studio of Mahesh. She spends quite some good time to get the basic makeup on, and she asks Mahesh to click her as good as possible as she wants to participate in the cover photo competition of Vanita magazine, and she shows the cover photos of some top actresses as a reference. Mahesh conducts a photo shoot and the photos turn out to be not so impressive, and Jimsy's irritation leads to self-doubt in Mahesh regarding his photography skills. After getting advice by his father, Mahesh decides to photograph Jimsy in motion, or what we call as candid clicks, and he sends the best photos of her in the most natural look to the magazine competition. Shortly later, Jimsy goes to Mahesh's house with the magazine containing that particular natural photo as the cover photo. Although she initially gets angry for photographing her without permission, but later she appreciates those natural clicks. Although Fahad Fazil was a lot appreciated for his performance in this movie, but Aparna Balamurli's perfection in playing the vivacious girl's role, impactful dialogue delivery, flexible dance moves, and most importantly her makeup-free looks was a lot appreciated by the fans and the critics. In an interview later, she quoted, "Jimsy is quite like me," and which is very true, because she is often seen in public events or at award functions, and also in her social media updates, often without makeup. "The idea that an actress should look flawless isn't valid anymore," she adds. "Comparing oneself to other women leads one depressed, and you should just follow what suits your body complexion and your body type." Number 2. Sai Pallavi in Premam, one of the most successful actors of the South industry currently. The movie Premam not only marked her entry into the Malayalam film industry, but also into the hearts of the Malayali audience. Although the movie had three main female characters, but the character of Malar teacher, played by Sai Pallavi, was the most appreciated and the most loved one by the audience. But what made this character stand out is that it embraced something what most teenagers consider to be their greatest ever insecurity. That is facial acne. In an interview with the leading media, Sai Pallavi spoke about how she had insecurities with her facial acne and how she overcame the same.
I was equally insecure. I tried a lot of creams, from medicines to anything that's organic, and you have any food item, I would put it on my face thinking, okay, I'm going to lose my acne and all of that. And I've always grown seeing actresses who were flawless, who were beautiful. They were just perfection. You would think that these people are born to act. But after I did my first film, Premam, I came to realize that people liked my character over there. I asked Alphonse, do you think that I should tweeze my eyebrows, cut my hair, do some makeup and all of that? He said, no, I just want you to be yourself. And after the release, all those insecurities that I had fell that minute. And then I saw teens who felt that they were not very confident about their looks or the beauty standards that the world had created. They saw an actor being appreciated for the way she is. So they said that, oh, if she's liked for the way she looks, maybe I don't look that different. And that gave me a sense of purpose. From then, I started developing as a person. You learn from the society. They teach you something, and in turn, you need to give it back.
And another key highlight of the movie was a simplistic dressing style to fit into the role of a real-life teacher. A movie which shares the same plot like that of Premam is the 2004 movie Main Hoon Na. Sushmita Sen played the role of a chemistry teacher named Chandini Chopra, who wears a designer sari to the college, and this is how she entered. And this is how Sai Pallavi entered in the movie Premam, in which the plot was set in the year
2005.
I'm not a student. I'm here to teach. I'm a guest lecturer.
No romantic BGM, no great cinematic shots. She just entered as another person walking around the campus wearing a simple sari, which was an ideal outfit of most of the teachers back then. Movies that portray characters close to real life are definitely the ones that strike close to our heart, and they remain there for eternity. And the Malayalam film industry has mastered this art better than anyone else. Number 3, Nimisha Sajen. Well, it is almost impossible to pick one particular movie from Nimisha's entire career, because most of her movies so far has seen her go with a no makeup look. Be it Shreeja from Thondi Mudram Drikshakshiyam, her role as a housewife in The Great Indian Kitchen, Sunita in Nayata, or Rosaline in Malik. Over the course of a very short time period, she has become a regular name in every household. With her bushy eyebrows, untamed wavy hair, and her no makeup at all except for a bit of kajal, Nimisha has looked absolutely natural on the screen in most of her movies so far. She won the Kerala State Best Actress Award for her performance in the movie Uru Kuprasiddha Payyan and Chola. But was it her glamour, her skin color, or her body type that got her all these achievements? Well, absolutely no. But her personal magnetism and her excellent skills should be credited. In a viral clip of a show called Annie's Kitchen, in which Nimisha appeared as a guest few years back, she can be seen confidently replying to how looks or makeup has never ever bothered her.
Film la makeup cheyidilla mole
ayya cheyidittilla
why
cheechi sadharana veetile pengutiyanu Shreeja ayalum nande adutha second movie le ammu ayalum Clara ayalum ippa naan cheyda oru kuprasidha payyanle Hanna Elizabeth ayalum appo enikku thonnu nammal ippa sadharana edu veetti poyalum cheechimarayalum aniyathi ayalum ammamarayalum makeup onnu idadeyaan ee cheedikkane.
She stood by her word till the end of the show in spite of all the nudging by the host Annie, who just could not let her go of the belief that fair skin is a mandate for an actress.
Celebrity ennu nilakku oru rendu karyangalundu endanu ariyo onnu nammude glamour adine nammal base cheyyum ichiri bangiyayittu irikkanam allengi nammude minus points okke mikkathu makeup il adjust cheyan pattum ennokke parayum appo adu nammal oru bhagam ee parnalla character korchu vrithiyayittu irikkanam
enikku angane onnum illa. എന്നെ സ്ക്രീനിൽ കണ്ട ക്യാരക്ടറായിട്ട് നോക്കിയാൽ മതി. എനിക്ക് ക്രിറ്റിസിസം കിട്ടാറുണ്ട് ഈ ഒരു കാര്യത്തിൽ. കുറേ ചേട്ടായിമാർ മെസ്സേജ് അയക്കും, ചേച്ചി എന്താ ചേച്ചി മേക്കപ്പ് ഇടാത്ത മേക്കപ്പ് ഇടാത്ത. അപ്പൊ എനിക്ക് അത്രേ പറയാനുള്ളൂ, ചേട്ടാ അത് എന്റെ പേഴ്സണൽ ലൈഫാണ്, അത് ഞാൻ എങ്ങനെ ജീവിച്ചു പോക്കോട്ടെ, എന്നെ വിട്ടേക്കൂ.
Annie, like a patriarch, is shocked by Nimisha's bold statement, and by the end of the show, she goes a little too far by advising Nimisha to try on some makeup.
അങ്ങനത്തെ ഒരു റോള് വരുവാണ് ചേച്ചി, നല്ല ഒരു റോള് വരുവാണ്, മേക്കപ്പ് ഇടുന്ന ഒരു കുട്ടിയാണെന്നൊക്കെ വരുവാണെങ്കിൽ ചിലപ്പോൾ ഇടും. അല്ലാതെ സാധാരണ വീട്ടിലെ പെൺകുട്ടികളായിട്ട് എന്തിന്?
ഓക്കേ, ഐ ഓൾവേസ് കമ്പയർ ദീസ് ക്യാരക്ടേഴ്സ് വിത്ത് ദ ഒറിജിനൽ ലൈഫ്.
യാ, ദാറ്റ്സ് ഇറ്റ്.
അതെ, അത് കറക്റ്റ്. ഇനി നിമിഷ വന്നിട്ട് ഈ പറഞ്ഞ പോലെ കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ മാറ്റട്ടെ, അതാ നല്ലത് അല്ലേ? കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ നമ്മൾ റൂൾസ് വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്, ഇന്ന പോലെ ചെയ്യണം, ഇന്ന പോലെ ചെയ്യണം,
നടിമാരെ മേക്കപ്പ് വേണം, ഭംഗി വേണം, അതൊന്നും വേണ്ട.
ബട്ട് നിമിഷ സ്റ്റേ സ്ട്രോങ് ടു വാട്ട് ഷീ ബിലീവ്സ് ബൈ എക്സ്പ്രസിംഗ് ദാറ്റ് ഇൻ ദ മോസ്റ്റ് പൊളൈറ്റ് വേ. And it is women like Nimisha who break the stigma around beauty standards and redefine it. The influence of media and celebrities on common people cannot be underestimated. They play a significant role in assisting people to learn and to unlearn myths and baseless beliefs. And with more people like Nimisha, Aparna and Sai Pallavi and more movies that normalize skin colors, all body types, various imperfections of the body and those that celebrate the natural beauty on the screen, it would be right to say that the Malayalam film industry is going to be in the safe hands. And while I speak about this topic, let me take this moment to quickly thank some of our all-time female legends who have carried the legacy of Malayalam cinema until now. Urvashi, Shobana, Manju Warrier, KPSC Lalitha, Revati, Kavyur Ponnamma, Parvati Jayaram, Sheila, Sukumari, Philomena, Kalpana, Seema, Kartika, Meera Jasmine, Kavya Madhavan, Bhavana, Parvati Tiruvut, Nayantara, Navya Nair, Anushree, and many more. These strong women have appeared in various lead as well as supporting roles, and they have portrayed characters close to real life with their exceptional acting. Their glamour or their beauty quotient is not what defines them today, but their talent and the iconic characters they have played is what does. The reason why I mentioned at the start of this video that the video is going to be about you and me is because most of us have grown up watching fair-skinned celebrities being adorned on the media. People are seen promoting whitening products as a must for beauty. From a very young age, we were being told that being dark means worse and being white means being better. I am sure that you have been body shamed at least once in your life for being fat or being thin. And in today's day and age, social media influencers and other digital stars portray a perfect skin or a perfect body type. And we often end up feeling sad for the way we look or the way we are. And we cannot let this mindset be passed on to our upcoming generation. So if you have ever been mocked for your skin color or your body type, always remember that there is nothing you have to fix. I do believe that movies have the power to change mindsets and perspectives. And with OTT platforms seeking Malayalam films at the global level, I am sure that no kid from the upcoming generation will fear for simply embracing who they really are. Because at the end of the day, no matter how many beauty standards or beauty parameters we set for ourselves, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder.